After 4 years away from the big screen, Ryan Gosling is back as the secretive Sierra Six in Netflix blockbuster The Gray Man, a role that feels tailor-made for both his brooding action chops and sly comedic charm.
I'm gonna bleed out while we have this conversation. Can we just unpack this somewhere else?
It's no surprise that he's capable of both carnage and chuckles. From the ultra-violence of Drive to the goofiness of The Nice Guys, there's no role the Canadian star can't make his own. So join us now as we follow Ryan Gosling's road to Netflix. An early hint of Ryan's versatility came in his first screen role in 1993 as a Mouseketeer in the all-new Mickey Mouse Club.
Well, actually, me and Jester were wondering how you guys got the name for your band, Escape.
Attending an open audition in Montreal, he beat 17,000 aspiring stars to appear on the show in a mix of sketches and variety performances, alongside the likes of Britney Spears, Christina Aguilera, and Justin Timberlake.
Ron, you dweebmeister!
Through the 90s, Ryan starred in a variety of children's TV shows, such as Are You Afraid of the Dark?
Hey, leave him alone!
Goosebumps and Breaker High, where he played Sean Stanley Hanlon, whose high school is located on a cruise liner.
Totally, I could be like Hootie, y'all could be my blowfish, what do you think, huh?
In 1998, he landed the lead role of Hercules in Young Hercules, which was an unusual mix of teen drama and Greek mythology, where going to parties is just as important as the machinations of the many gods.
Let's have real fun!
The show ran for 50 episodes, giving Ryan a taste of the leading man life. Early film roles leaned on his teen TV roots, with appearances as high school footballers in both Remember the Titans and The Slaughter Rule. In 2001, he took on more serious parts, playing a conflicted neo-Nazi Jew in The Believer and a manipulative killer in 2002 Sandra Bullock thriller Murder by Numbers.
Bang!
You're dead.
While these early films show Ryan's potential, it was 2004's The Notebook that made him a global star. The swooning romance focuses on Gosling's Noah and Rachel McAdams' Ally, whose star-crossed relationship is forbidden by her parents. Not only does this classic love story showcase Gosling's movie star charisma and matinee idol appeal, it also features one of the all-time great Hollywood smooches.
Still isn't over.
A kiss the pair famously recreated at the MTV Movie Awards. Less snogging followed. In 2006, he nabbed his first Best Actor nomination, playing a teacher struggling with drug addiction in Half Nelson. And in 2007, locked horns with another Oscar-winning legend, taking on a very shifty Anthony Hopkins in courtroom thriller Fracture. Later that year, in Lars and the Real Girl, he fell in love with a sex doll.
You know, Bianca's a missionary.
Hey, to each their own. Ryan's on-screen relationships weren't much healthier in 2010. Blue Valentine charted the deterioration of his marriage to Michelle Williams in excruciating detail, while All Good Things cast him as a wealthy playboy accused of murdering Kirsten Dunst. Don't worry, things get a bit lighter in 2011 with two very different fan favourites, showing off his electric chemistry with Emma Stone in Crazy Stupid Love.
Seriously? It's like you're photoshopped.
And demonstrating his handiness with a getaway car in Drive. Needless to say, this was a little edgier than Jacob in Crazy Stupid Love. He also earned a Golden Globe nomination for The Ides of March, where his earnest political campaigner is pulled into George Clooney's web of deceit. Ryan played another bad boy with a heart of gold across from Eva Mendes in 2012's sprawling epic, The Place Beyond the Pines. He plays a carnival bike rider who takes up bank robbing to support his infant son. 2013 saw Ryan revisit two classic partnerships. And no, it's not the doll from Lars and the Real Girl. Gangster Squad reignited the flame with Emma Stone, set to the background of a 1940s gangland war. While Only God Forgives reunited him with Drive director Nicholas Winding Refn for more bone-crunching fun.
You wanna fight?
We saw more of Ryan's lighter side in 2015's The Big Short, a film all about the financial crisis of 2008. Not the most obvious rib-tickling material, but Ryan's spray-tanned motor-mouth finance bro Jared is a hilarious creation. He even helped us get our heads around complex financial concepts.
Somewhere along the line, these B's and double B's went from a little risky to dog shit. Where's the trash?
There are more laughs in 2016 with the riotously fun The Nice Guys. Playing the sort of brains to Russell Crowe's brawn, Ryan delivered brilliant slapstick. While showcasing facial hair only recently matched by Chris Evans in The Gray Man. 2016 also gave us his acclaimed performance in La La Land. Earning his second Oscar nomination, this is Ryan at his most swooningly charismatic, as Sebastian, a jazz pianist who dreams of one day running his own jazz club, before he falls for Emma Stone's Nia. Come on, own up. Who bought a cool hat after this one?
City of stars, are you shining just for me?
In 2017, Ryan was at the center of one of the biggest sequels in sci-fi history, Blade Runner 2049. As replicant Officer K, Ryan is at his stoic best, easily holding his own against cinema icon Harrison Ford, when the two aren't punching each other in the face.
I don't want to hurt you, but you're not making it easy.
No face punching in Song to Song, however, an intimate drama directed by legendary auteur Terrence Malick. Amazingly, 2018's First Man, a retelling of Neil Armstrong's journey to the moon, was the last film Ryan starred in before returning in 2022's The Gray Man. And what a return. It mixes his steely determination with natural comedic timing.
Emotionally, I've been better.
A timely reminder of his many talents, whether that's trying to outwit highly trained mercenaries or just a very, very evil Chris Evans. He follows this next year as a frankly sensational-looking Ken in the official Barbie movie, continuing his incredible run. For now, make sure to head to Netflix to check out The Gray Man and be sure to subscribe to Still Watching Netflix for all the info you could ever want on your favourite shows and films.